Hi and welcome to this video on the official Raspberry Pi 3 case. I just wanted to do a really short video to show you how to open it in case anyone has just got one and is unsure how to open it, just doesn't want to make sure that they do any damage to it. So as you can see, this is literally a brand new one, so I will take it out of its packet. Not an awful lot to say about this. There's two-tone colours going on here. You can basically pop off anything that is white on this case. So in the case of the lid here, which is the first thing I would tend to go for, I tend to sort of grab the two sides and just rock it literally from one side across like that. A little bit of a click, and you can see on the lid itself, you might be able to just about make up that there are notches, etc. On here. That's all that's actually holding it in place, which is why all I'm doing is rocking it literally side to side to lift those notches there out of there. Positions on the red part of the case here. You could do exactly the same on the white elements. I tend to prefer to take the top off when it's brand new, and then you can actually just push from the inside. I tend to hold the outside just so it doesn't go flying anywhere, but that will literally just click off. Again, very simple, couple of notches on there just holding it in place, and the very same on the other side. So a bit of outside pressure brings you back to the basic shell. At this point, it's these arrows that should be the key piece of information for you. That's the direction of travel, in effect. So you're going to push in on those and pull in the direction that that's pointing. There are, at the back here, if I can make it visible, there are almost hinges in a way. They're not literal hinges, but you don't want to be pulling from that side of the case. Those will hold that part of the case sturdy. So I'm going to literally apply pressure on both of those triangular sections and then pull in that particular direction that they're saying, and it will just sort of hinge outwards, as you can see. You can actually see there are just sticky feet there that are in the middle as it's brand new. So yeah, these are the elements that I was just referring to there. So in order to reverse this, because obviously at this point this is the most broken down that the case becomes, so you could now put your Raspberry Pi in the middle there. To put it back together, we're going to have to first of all place those two elements together, what I call the hinge generally. Once those are in place, it's literally just a case of pushing these together. What is worth noting, you don't actually have to push down on both of these triangular sections. So with the Raspberry Pi in place, let's assume that that particular side there, that you've got it powered up, etc., and you want to open it at this point, you can actually get away with just pressing the single side. You obviously have no access on this particular side to that hinge, so you can get away with just literally pressing that one side there, and that will break apart without impacting there, and therefore the ports that are obviously connected at that time. I think that's pretty much everything to show you about the case. As I say, it just literally push all the way back together, literally just push into place, given that we're clicking back outwards, and that will return it all to normal. You may not be able to get the lid on if you've got any extras on the very top of your Raspberry Pi, but in a normal scenario, that all just clicks straight back together there.
If you found this video useful, please like it, and ideally subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.